model will define the tokenomics, the utility token propagation, or how Quadrant is making money.
Ну, проект, естественно, но это и есть экономика токена, это одно и то же.
Yes, first of all, Quad is a utility token. That means that enables access on our products. If you hold Quad tokens, you can buy data sets, you can buy services from our data engineers, you can buy products from Milon. So when, as a company, we have sellers who are not going who are not going to take those money, all that resources, they need utility tokens to purchase them. We keep a very, very small percentage of those sales.
Можете перевести?
Окей. So, who was it?
Да кратко.
Quad is a utility token. That means you're not buying this to take a share from our company's profits. Though, as though there are secondary markets called crypto exchanges that list those tokens, and few people they speculate if they are going up or if they are going down, but this is totally unrelated with our company. We don't monitor the market and we're not responsible for that. So this is something totally different. As a utility
Можно
token,
по-другому задам вопрос. А вот в блокчейне, in blockchain utility token, ну, комиссии.
What are the commissions? How do you work with the commissions in utility tokens on your platform?
Commissions for the services in Quadrant ecosystem. Because the ecosystem is now being developed, there are not structured yet. I can't tell you with confidence that it's going to be like 1%. I know that it's going to be really low. That's why we're working on the blockchain. Everything is going to be automated.
And
our company, our company is not going to make money from running the guardians, since we're going to outsource and it's going to be operated by other people, but we will continue to support ecosystem as consultants. That means if a bank, probably a bank if it's going to buy from us, they will need us well consulting services. So as the people who created the ecosystem, we are going to have dedicated services for them. But it doesn't mean we're going to be the only party. We are welcome to competitors. So if the Russian data science company wants to utilize our technologies and open source, we cannot intervene.
Ну, вот это...
Поэтому они приветствуют конкурентов и приветствуют любых участников данной экосистемы для того, чтобы данные проходили через Marketplace, но при этом запрос на обработку данных и конституционные услуги шли уже со стороны Quadrant.
We're selling and transacting data since 2014 with the previous structure, DataStreamX. So we have several clients. Now we're going just to use Quadrant's technology to provide
Ну да, ну понятно. Но в тестовой сети какая комиссия?
It really varies because we have a few clients who are buying thousands, millions of data monthly. So it really depends. And I guess you have confidential agreements that we can disclose.
Значение, которое они не могут раскрывать, к сожалению, сейчас. И
now we have the
Okay.
May I ask a question about the design of the product itself? So there was no place for, you said there are data producers, but not from the perspective of you as a, like as a user, right?
Yes.
Was it ever like in design to have?
No, it's not. It's not going to happen. We're not targeting individuals, but there are other blockchain companies promising that you own the data. I'm not sure, I'm not an expert who answer how they're going to do it, but we don't target individuals.
Okay. You will explain about the regulations in the next section, right?
Yes, yes. In about the European
GDPR,
Union?
Yeah, the GDPR.
No, I'm not going to speak about GDPR, but the facade of European law, so I might be able to help you.
European law, like it has to follow the GDPR, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And also GDPR is not limited to businesses that are based in Europe.
Yeah,
even Russian companies
are
needed to follow GDPR.
There was one last question. It's a little bit technical, maybe if you know the answer to it. So it was explained in the video that Quantum Protocol wants to preserve the integrity of the data. So for example, if I take a data set from one of the producers in the network and add their dot or something like that, and then create a hash of the data, it will be a different hash, right? So he showed it in the example. And for example, then one of the Elons, or whatever was the name of the engineers there, they discovered that this is the same like set of data. That this is the same like set of data, but with a dot there. So it's basically like a fake of data now. I mean, it's the same data, like if you with some useless data, but then impersonated as a new data.
Let me explain how it's going to work. Maybe
yeah,
the translation, there was an issue with translation, I'm not sure though, the video didn't explain it correctly.
No, it was, I understand that it was not the full question, I'm sorry. So I understand that it's pretty like hard to identify that, but will one of the solutions it can be like to have a reputation of
yes, this is going to be part of the ecosystem after
okay.
Your
pass. It was not like set on that there. It was like another like okay, you live it on.
It's going to have a reputation system.
Okay.
That means you will know the feedback from previous clients who used those data sets.
Yeah,
will not intervene as a company. Also, if there is any technical question, I'm not coming from a technical background, but you can address it today, and I'm going to follow up with the technical team in Singapore and send you an email tomorrow. Or you can just ask it in our Telegram community.
Понятно.
Что, друзья, к чаю приглашаемся к вас. А после брейка, чайного брейка, говорим про регулирование, где